Are you hurting and broken thin? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end? Good morning, brothers and sisters. Praise the Lord. We hope the Lord has been faithful to you as he has been faithful to us. We want to welcome you to today's service. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we want to thank you this morning for allowing us to see yet another Sunday, and Abba Father giving us an opportunity to come and pray. We honor you and we praise your holy name. Thank you, Abba Father, because you've been our King this far. Help us, Lord, as we begin today's service, and guide us to the end. We ask all this through Jesus Christ, who taught us how to pray. Together, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. At this moment, brothers and sisters, I'll request you to please stand up where you are, if you're seated, as we begin today's service by singing a hymn. Have come together, the people of God, drawn by his Spirit, longing for his word, to praise the holy name of the Lord, to share his glorious news of grace, to pray for our needs and the pain of the world, to rejoice in his love and be sent in his peace. We are heirs of the Father, renewed in the Spirit. Do not think that I came to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. If we say we have no sins, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins in repentance and trust, God is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins. So let us confess them to our Father. So together as we sit down or kneel, Eternal Father, God of our ancestors, before your power all things tremble, but through your Son we approach your throne. We have done wrong and neglected to do right. Our sins weigh heavily on our hearts. Lord, have mercy. Count them not against us. Grant us the joy of forgiveness. Enlighten our hearts with the glory of Christ, who died and rose again for us. Amen. Lord of mercy, grant us your pardon and peace that cleansed from our sins, and with peace in our hearts, we may be free to serve you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are those who live in your house, singing your praise. Praise the Lord. Let us all stand up as we glorify the Father. Glory to the Father in whom all things began. Glory to the Son who became the Son of Man. Glory to the Spirit who inspires and renews, the Lord our God forever. Hallelujah. While we are still standing, we continue standing together with Christians throughout the centuries and throughout the world today to affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. This moment we will pray with the prayer appointed for the day. Today is the 16th Sunday after Trinity. Let us pray. O God, our King and lover of children, you demand of all who would inherit your kingdom to be like children in character. Open our eyes and deepen our faith and loyalty to you, that shunning the deceptions of worldly riches, we may carry our cross and faithfully follow you without ever looking back. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this moment, brothers and sisters, we are going to sing a hymn.
Christians, greetings. I want to thank the Lord for making it possible for us to be here, to listen to him as he speaks to us through the word in the book of Genesis chapter number 17, verse 1 to verse 7. I will read. When Abram was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, "I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. I will confirm my covenant between me and you and greatly increase your numbers." Abram fell face down, and God said to him, "As for me, this is my covenant with you. You will be the father of many nations. No longer will you be called Abraham. Your name will be Abraham. For I have made you a father of many nations. I will make you very fruitful. I will make nations of you, and kings will come from you. I will establish my covenant as an everlasting covenant between me and you and your descendants after you for this generation to come, to be your God and the God of your descendants after you." That is the word of the Lord. Everlasting Lord, we want to thank you because of giving us an opportunity to sit under your feet. Talk to us, because we, your servants, we are listening. In Jesus' name, amen. God is so gracious to us that each and every time he creates a moment for us, and he keeps on trying to reach to each one of us through many ways, and by this time, through his word. The text that I have just read, it was a very momentous time for Abraham, because at this time he was 99 years old. And if you read chapter 16, at the end, you'll find that God has been silent for 13 years because Abraham had sought for a plan B of having a son. And that is why he impregnated Hagar and bore him a son called Ishmael. And that was totally not God's plan. And this time round, God appeared to Abraham, and he introduces himself very well, that I am God the Almighty, meaning that God cannot be hindered by anything or anyone or any situation. He's above everything. And that is an assurance that he was giving this man of God called Abraham. And he appears to walk to him in an upright manner and be blameless. That is why he says very well in verse 1, walk before me and be blameless. He's appealing to Abraham, come to me, reach out to me and be blameless. And very fast, I want us to acclimatize the word walk. That is, you write the word walk downward. And we start with W. Because we want to approach the throne of mercy blamelessly. And therefore, W stands for we should engage God's wisdom. We need God's wisdom. Many are times that we are spending a lot of time looking for knowledge. And no wonder that is why we go to school. We are taught from basics going upward to a level where you feel that you can't absorb anymore. But when it comes to matters of wisdom, it is only acquired. It is something that can only be a gift from above. And no wonder this king called Solomon had this insight. If you read the book of 1 Kings, chapter number 3, verse 12, he asked for wisdom. He never mentioned about wealth. He never asked God to give him wives, but he asked for wisdom. And in verse 12, it is very well recorded that God said, I will give him what he has asked for, and also I'll add more. Because when you have wisdom, you have a discerning heart. You have everything with you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us ask God to give us wisdom. Because when we have wisdom with us, we are able to navigate issues of life. The other letter is A, action, the word of God. When you action the word of God, you are in a position to defeat your enemy. And the enemy knows people who do not action the word of God. The devil knows. You know, the Satan was in heaven at one given time. He was in close relationship with God. So he knows very well what is up there in heaven. And he would like so many people to miss it. And that is why Jesus came. And he showed us a good example. When he was taken, when he was in wilderness, and the devil took challenge Jesus. But Jesus defeated the devil by telling him, "It is written." He was actioning the word of God. We are only going to defeat the devil when we action the word of God. The other letter, according to the acronym of the word walk, is L. Lean on God. Brothers and sisters, lean on God. Why? Because he is everlasting. If you lean against the king of this world, their throne are falling apart. If you lean against your friend, they can crumble any time. If you lean against the riches of this world, which is unstable, you will collapse with them. Lean and learn the word. The other letter is K. Know who you believe. I like this one. Know who you believe. Because Abraham believed in God, and he was an alien. He came to believe in God. He came to believe in God. And he followed God. Your faith is the one that is going to help you to know who you believe. I like when I read the book of Job, chapter number 19, verse 25. Job, to a certain time, he said, "I know my Redeemer liveth." Do you believe in God? If so, you can be able to say like Job, that "I know my Redeemer liveth." No matter the situation, no matter the circumstance that you are facing through, you are going through, if you know who you believe in, definitely you are going to trust in him. As we read in the text, there are the benefits. There are some benefits that follows a person who walks before the Lord and who is blameless. One we have read in verse 5, no longer will you be called Abraham. Abram, your name will be changed to Abraham. Abraham literally means exalted father. But Abraham means a father of a great nation. When we walk before the Lord and we are blameless, situations changes in our lives, both the physical one and also in the spiritual one. There is a change, a paradigm change, paradigm shift in our lives. There is also another benefit in verse 6 that says, "I'll make you very fruitful." When we walk before the Lord and we are blameless, we become fruitful in each and everything that we undertake. And that is why, brethren, I would encourage you And our appeal to you, those who have not known Christ, to come on board, because you are going to experience a great manifestation of God in your life. You shall be called blessed. And another point, another benefit of walking before the Lord and be blameless is in verse 7, that God will establish his covenant from one generation to the other. And when God talks about establishment, he talks about greatness that is in you. The seed that is in you of greatness will be seen. And I don't mean about, when I talk about greatness, I don't mean having those big names, having the half of the world being yours. The Bible helps me to understand when it talks about greatness, it talks about having that fulfilling and satisfying life. Whatever you touches, wherever you are, wherever you are working, you are full of the life become fulfilling and satisfying. That is what the Bible talks about when it talks about establishment. God will establish you from one generation to the other. May we purpose to walk before the Lord and be blameless. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
I can hear my Savior calling. I can hear my Savior calling. I can hear my Savior calling. Take thy cross and follow me.
Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will follow. Where he leads me, I will follow. I'll go with him, with him, all the way.
I'll go with him through the garden. I'll go with him through the garden. I'll go with him through the garden. I'll go with him, with him, all the way.
I'll go with him through the judgment. I'll go with him through the judgment. I'll go with him through the judgment. I'll go with him, with him.
He will give me grace.
Let us have a word of prayer as we commit this giving to God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gifts that you give to us. Thank you for the work and the places of work that we go and toil so that we can get the benefit of what we have worked for. In return, we give back to you. These gifts that have been given by your people, we commit them before you so that you can bless them, sanctify them, and separate them from what may not be pleasant before you. Bless the people who have given. Bless the tithers. Bless those who have given in any form or any kind. May you continue blessing them as they give to you. We commit this offertory before you and each giver before you that they may experience the blessing that you have in store for them. And now we commit you before the Lord, who is able to do more exceedingly abundantly more than you can ask or imagine. May the Lord be with you. May the Lord keep you. And may he make his face shine upon you and give you peace. And the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit be with you. Remain with your beloved ones near and far from now and forevermore. Amen.